This is the EcoFlow app for the EcoFlow River Pro 2. Here you can see it gives you a nice depiction of the EcoFlow product right there, as well as a percentage when it's turned on. If it's not turned on, you wouldn't see this. So right now I have this powering two items, and there you can see what's left. If I select my EcoFlow River Pro 2, you're brought to this screen. This is one of two different screens that you can have as your home screen. Right now you can see time remaining 33 hours, 57 minutes, and it's getting close to 44%. This is based on I have things drawing from my River Pro currently. Input, you can see AC is zero, USB is zero, and solar is zero. But if I come over here to my output, we can see that from the USB-A port, I have 3 watts, and from my USB-C port, I have 7 watts being generated, as well as I have the name up there and a little Wi-Fi indicator letting you know that I'm connected. You'll notice that the AC and DC are both currently at zero and off, but there is a toggle. So if I turn this on, it will actually turn on the AC outlets on the River Pro without actually having to do that on the unit itself. And you can see dynamically that changes as things are happening. In the upper right-hand corner, this is our settings for the unit. Selecting this will bring us into a lot of extra menus. Starting off, you have the rename. So if I wanted to give this River Pro a different name, here we have our device sharing. Selecting this will allow you to invite somebody with the EcoFlow app to share in the management of the River Pro. Here we have energy management. This will allow you to set limitations, which is a great thing that I like about EcoFlow, in that they give you these extra options after the fact, allowing you to customize and update their products, unlike some other solar generators. Here you can see I set a limit where I will not allow it to discharge past 10%. I at one time loaned out my previous River Pro to somebody and they drained it all the way to zero. Didn't like that. If I wanted to, I could also prevent it from charging over 80%. But since I'm still in my testing phases of things, I want to see how quickly it'll charge. Down here, we have our backup reserve. If I toggle this on, you'll notice that there's now an extra bit here. And that energy reserve is so that if you have a blackout, hey, don't let it fall below this point before telling me I need to charge it. And that's all under our energy management. Down here, we have our input information, AC charging speed. Well, it's customizable. I have it at the max of 940 watts, but you can drop it all the way down to 100 watts. Same with our car input. We have 4 amp, 6 amp, and 8 amp. And then our DC mode, well, right now I have it on auto, but if we select that, we can say solar charging or car charging. With auto, it will dynamically switch between the two depending on what you have plugged in. Coming down to our output information, here we have X-Boost. Well, X-Boost is that EcoFlow specific thing that will allow you to utilize devices that might not quite be able to be handled by the output. This will lower the voltage to that device, thereby allowing it to be used. But if you're using something like a heat gun or a hairdryer, you will actually hear a difference in the sound it makes because it's not getting the proper voltage. Use sparingly, but that's how you can turn that on and off. Next, we have auto timeout. So unit timeout, I have it for never. As long as I don't push the button to turn it off, it will remain on indefinitely. However, screen timeout, I have it set for 5 minutes, and then AC timeout, meaning it'll turn off the AC outlets after 6 hours. If you are actively using this for a CPAP or something in a blackout situation, you're gonna wanna have unit never timeout and then make sure your ACs also don't timeout. Coming down to other, we have firmware. This, if I select this and there was a firmware, it would let me know to update it. This is the great thing about EcoFlow in that they constantly update their units. Right here, we have lab features. Selecting this will let you know, hey, what do we have? Well, right here, we have automations. So I can select AC charging, solar charging, AC discharge, and then 12 volt DC discharging. So if I select AC, well, here, the unit will stay active under blah, 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 solar timing. This is pretty much an if this, then that situation built in now under the lab features for now, but that's really cool that they'll allow you to do that. And then we also have our AC always on, which is another feature allowing it to turn itself on or off depending on specifics that you input. Help and feedback, well, there you go. All the information you need, specifications. This is gonna let you know a lot of the information as well as the serial number, which is out of view at the moment, but letting you know your capacity, your outputs for everything. So anything you wanna know, right under there, under specifications. Homepage, this is new. Right now I have it on the standard, which looks like this. And you can see if I was inputting something, it would have a line letting you know. They also have an energy flow homepage. So we'll select this really quickly. Even this one is different than what it looked like on the original EcoFlow products. The older EcoFlow products still have the old app styling. Newer ones will have something like this. Here are our outputs. It's going to DC. I can toggle on and off my AC and DC from here. If I had the AC on, it could show it over there, showing you time remaining, nothing being inputted. Notice here, it doesn't show you what's actually being utilized. So if I come back up here and I come back to this one, when I look at my output, I can see where that's going. And for me, that is a little better than the energy flow style. And last on this page is actually unit temperature, so Celsius or Fahrenheit. Fact that EcoFlow allows you to have an app that lets you make those changes, that lets you make those updates for their solar generators, always a plus.